scared of that.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Austin Avenue. My name is Don't Play It. Golly gee. Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Austin Avenue. I am, of course, Austin. And today joining me is...
Anna.
Today we're going to be, we're going to be reacting to and responding to in a really just gentle, thoughtful way. The Man music video by Taylor Swift. Now, if you have not already read my article that I wrote about Taylor Swift's song, The Man, when it first came out, please go back and read that. The description has that link right in it. It'll say Austin's, it'll be very clear. It'll be very clear. But the reason why Anna is here is because she likes rhetorically critiquing as well. And Anna is a woman. And so she brings another perspective, a perspective that, let's face it, I don't have. And just a progressive woman at that. She is a local feminist. She is just a local advocate for women everywhere. Wow.
Okay. All right.
So she's going to be helping me perhaps in my... since I'm a pro-masculinity man, if you're a feminist, then I'm a masculinist.
Well, you could also be a feminist because the definition of feminist means equality for men and women.
Wow, look at that. She's already adding content. This is why we have women around here.
Yes.
So yes, also a feminist, I would probably say with that definition, with fighting for equality, I would say I'm a feminist too. Also a masculinist, which would be equal treatment of men, I would say.
Yeah.
So let's see if there's equal treatment of men here. Have not watched this video. I'm a little excited slash... being that the lyrics are pretty pro a mixed view of manhood and masculinity and what manhood is, I don't have great hopes for this music video, but we're about to find out, and I'm excited to call Taylor Swift into some more critical thinking and perhaps, yeah, love to call Taylor Swift out. Mm-hmm. Not that she's ever gonna really watch this or care.
Just in case.
Thoughts from you?
I have never seen this video. I have never
heard of
this
Swift.
Song. I also have never heard of Taylor Swift. She's the one who Kanye stole her Grammy, right?
Correct.
Okay.
Well,
awesome.
Something happened.
Yes.
Yeah. I did watch Miss Americana.
I did not. I don't know what
that's the documentary about Taylor Swift.
Okay.
That did have that moment in it.
Okay.
But we're getting off topic. We're getting off topic at the topic. Ma'am?
Yes.
Press play.
All right.
I wonder if this is Taylor Swift. Can we tell?
It's not. It's definitely not Taylor Swift. I don't think so. Taylor Swift has such like a small body.
I know, but it would totally make sense for her to do that.
That's true.
So who is this?
This is the man. The man.
Ah, this is the man.
Yes, I believe so.
Is that the fearless leader?
Oh, I'd be the man.
Yeah, look at all these people cheering. Okay, let's pause it.
Okay.
Have you ever, there's this, we have the man, just man spreading, I guess, on the subway. Have you ever seen someone doing that before?
Yes.
Just not... like that, where arms around women around him?
Oh, yes, absolutely.
Really?
Yes.
Wow. I'll say I've never seen that happen before, but sure.
Yes.
Okay.
Well, it is common for men who are very disrespectful. So it's not common for men who are just living their life like a regular, respectful individual. It is common for people who are trying to, it's called peacocking. Have you heard of peacocking?
I've heard Peacock by Katy Perry.
I wanna see you.
If somebody is peacocking, they are trying to present themselves as like big and, you know, when a peacock gets their feathers out?
Yeah.
So they're trying to present themselves as like something that is large and in the room and the main focus. And so when a man is manspreading, he's peacocking.
But isn't like everyone kind of supposed to be large to like help their confidence? I've heard like psychologists say like you stand large to help yourself be confident anyway.
Yeah, definitely.
So
but
is that
peacocking?
That?
No. So peacocking is more of a term for men who are trying to pick up somebody.
Somebody.
Yeah.
Got it. Wait a second. Let's look at this. The stuff happening.
Yeah. Do you see this? Yeah,
I see boss
Scotch. Capitalize on the feeling. And like he's sitting just like him.
He's sitting just like him. And there's Mother Nature doesn't stand a chance, man versus taste. You know what I'm more likely to see on what? Any kind of advertisement? A woman's half naked body.
A sexy, yeah, sexy. Yeah.
So I'm not sure that woman. I'm not sure they're going to sell any scotch with that.
I really don't think so.
So I think in advertising, well, here's a great statistic that women get paid gargantuan amounts more than men in modeling.
Really?
Male models get paid much less than female models. So this kind of feels like a forced moment here, because
definitely
it would be better to be a woman and be a model, because women are bound to get paid more. I'll go ahead and put the link in the description, but that's a true statistic.
I totally believe that.
Yeah, women get paid much more in modeling. So, yeah. Anyway, continue.
Okay,
all right.
Ready to play it?
Yep, we're 38 seconds in.
Okay. Poor woman.
No, that lady doesn't look she's doing well anyway.
He just ashed his cigar on her.
Well, again, smoking is not legal on a subway. Should we go back?
Did you see what that said?
What did it say?
I don't know. I want to see. Oh,
For
men with real thirst. It's men against boys and no ladies around. So this newspaper is ridiculous.
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 But it is called The News. The newspaper is called The News.
The News.
What is it?
And
men, it's men against boys with no ladies around. I don't understand what that means.
I don't.
Does that mean something?
I think that just means like it's trying to say that women are not in the workplace.
It's men against boys though?
It's men against boys? Yeah, because like boys who are trying to become men, I suppose. I don't know. It really does not.
All right, Taylor, we didn't understand that. Thank you. Next.
Taylor.
All right, let's keep playing. We've got some diversity on the subway though, so that's good.
We do, yes. All women, but all different ages.
Oh, there's a lot happening here. Oh my god. I've seen so many men pee on the wall in a subway station.
Oh, absolutely.
You know what? That's a huge male privilege. Lots of men peeing everywhere.
Oh my gosh. Can I actually tell you a funny story, though?
Yes. Real quick. Have you ever seen a man pee on the wall in a subway station?
This is the funny story.
Okay, here it comes. I've never seen that. I've only seen men peeing in public when it's in like camping, when I've done camping, because
yes.
I'm a
Eagle Scout. So just quick flex, guys. Austin is an Eagle Scout, so if you guys ever need to tie your shoes, let him know.
That feels offensive, but I'm just not kidding. A huge fan of the Boy Scouts anyway.
Anyways, I know. But anyways,
funny story, here it comes.
Yes,
everyone.
So my funny story is I used to work at this bar, and I was at the bar the other night, and while I was standing there, all of a sudden a man went over to the coat closet and started peeing in it.
Was he?
He was very inebriated. He was far past sober.
So in that case, have you seen other people?
It was
inebriated,
ridiculous.
Picky, women
pee? Also pee all over the place.
Okay.
But I just thought that was a funny story. Just to add, we don't have to add that in the video.
Okay. But. So we're a minute and 5 seconds in, and so far we've Taylor Swift has created this character, which I'm thinking
is a little outlandish.
Well, might be Taylor Swift. We'll see. I'm thinking it might be her. But because she does that in her other music videos, do you remember You Belong With Me?
Yes.
She was both characters.
Yes, I do remember that.
Also, mm-hmm. Avril Lavigne did that as well, I think. Well, yes. Did she?
I don't know much about her.
Taylor Swift has created this character. He's very wealthy, I guess. He's successful. Not really someone you'd want to be, so I'm not really sure what the...
Definitely not.
But she's kind of creating a stereotype.
Yes, absolutely.
Which, again, I'm not sure how accurate the stereotype is, but we'll keep playing.
Perfect.
And he peed on the
wall
and said the man.
Subway,
that's a
yes.
talent. If I could do that, I would probably...
He has got a lot of ladies.
I would wear that shirt in a second.
Oh, yeah. But also, a man was serving him.
Yeah.
Did you notice that? What is that?
Yeah,
what is that?
What does that mean?
Because it was supposed to be. It was because in the newspaper it said, "Man, what was it? Man helping boys or something?
No,
no
man
ladies
against
around.
Boys.
Oh, man against boys, no ladies around. I don't know.
Yep. All right, we're still unclear.
Yes.
Not sure what I'm trying to get from this, except that this guy is.
Oh wow.
Alpha man.
Yes,
of.
He is alpha man for sure.
Look at all those girls.
Wow. Look at all those ladies. Oh.
Okay.
He just used the champagne to slick his hair back.
That's
disgusting.
That's ideal.
And also probably sticky.
Now, picture
of him. Picture of himself. Oh my gosh.
What is this supposed to mean?
I don't know.
We've got...
And now he has a daughter, but he's...
He's on the phone. He's surrounded...
Checking out a woman. Did you see that?
That is weird. They're so happy that he's...
That he has the baby.
Throwing the daughter.
Oh my god. World's greatest dad.
Wow.
Because he pat her on the head once.
Okay, I probably have. Okay. I've probably witnessed guys talking like that before,
yeah.
So that's pretty accurate.
I've not seen. Yeah. I've never been to a strip club, so maybe I just don't understand that part.
Yeah. I've never either. Women's charity, not sure what this is. I've seen that motion before too, I guess.
Yeah, I have.
I don't know if I've done it, but. Oh.
Oh no.
Wow.
He broke the racket and hit
that racket.
Oh, he's sobbing. Is he sobbing?
Oh, 58 years later. Okay, let's see what's happening.
Is he getting...
Oh.
Oh, he's a
she's
sugar
pretty.
Daddy.
Wow.
Ew.
Yep, she's
oh
holding up.
Oh my gosh. The largest ring I've ever
so
seen.
Wouldn't that be kind of goes... I don't understand how that's... Like, the man... If you can be a young woman and you want to... If you can get someone's money by just marrying this old guy,
okay.
Why? No one's forcing you to marry an old man, and she's loaded now, right?
I mean, personally think that sugar daddies are a no-no on the female, because I think that is...
What do you mean a no-no on the female?
Like, I just think that is so rude, the fact that they are marrying someone solely for their bank account.
Yeah, that's very...
Yeah.
And he's marrying her solely probably for the...
For the way that she looks and the stuff under her clothes.
Yeah, the stuff under her clothes, yeah. So, that seems like less a privilege and more of a win-win, like if you're going to be shallow. You've got shallow one and shallow two.
Right.
Great pair.
Mm-hmm.
We've got very... One person who values the flesh and one who values the material.
Correct.
So what I'm saying is, like, if the roles were reversed, an old woman is marrying a young man for, like,
a cougar.
That's not an ideal, though. Like, that's not something, like, we should...
Absolutely not.
Why would we be applauding that?
Yeah,
like, come on, women! Get out there and marry someone just for their body.
Oh, my goodness.
You should be more like men.
Yes.
Okay. Let's
also, the more important question in this shot, do you think that is Taylor Swift?
I don't think that is.
Oh.
I really don't understand
this part at all.
That you just... What is the message?
He's just high-fiving and fist-bumping. Maybe it's like you're just getting congrats from everyone and it doesn't matter like who, like the color, gender doesn't matter. That's why they're just arms in the wall,
but
possibly.
So what is the message there? Okay, so perhaps let's say that that's what's happening. That's the metaphor, but what does it mean? Everyone's just for you, but that's not true. That's not an accurate that's not accurate in our world.
Yeah.
Literally, there are places, there are jobs that say mm-hmm. straight white males need not apply. Like, this happens, people. Can you imagine how fast fired would happen if any other person was inserted there? White women need not apply.
Yes.
Black men need not apply.
Yes. It's
also we'll throw that link in the description. So that's not true.
Exact story. So my roommate's boyfriend, he was trying to get a job at an ice cream parlor nearby, and he had dropped off his application, dropped off his resume, and then he walked in there and he was like, "Hey guys, I dropped off my application. There's a now hiring sign on the door. I was just curious as to why I haven't gotten a call back yet. Do you need me to give you more references or something like that?" And the employee was not the manager. Was just an employee, but the person who was working at the time told him and said, "Honestly, I don't want you to waste your time, and I'm just gonna let you know right now that we actually do not hire men." Like, at an ice cream parlor.
So, like, okay. I just can't. I cannot even. Press play. Let's get through this.
Oh my gosh.
Miss Americana, Taylor Swift, I saw that.
Oh my gosh.
That's what I said I saw.
Yes. Oh no. Oh, he's literally...
I have seen men adjust themselves in public. That happens. I've probably done that myself too.
That does happen, but that's just like a general anatomy thing.
I think everyone gets angry on
sports things. I think that might
be
Taylor
though.
Swift, yeah. That does not look like a male's body. Wait, what's up with those legs though? Those are not Taylor's legs.
Was that last thing more what you had in mind?
That's not Taylor's voice. That's Taylor.
Could you try to be sexier? Maybe more likable this time?
Okay. Okay.
Is that, okay, is that like, is that a nod to maybe something she's been told?
Yes, I think so.
Is that a, like a little jab at that?
I think that that is absolutely, yeah.
Okay, so there, she's creating this dichotomy where, again, like this role reversal.
Oh, so this could have to do with the subway. Because you remember on the subway how all the posters were of men? And that's not
I know,
accurate?
But every other environment...
The man has been, yeah.
...did not represent a role reversal.
There is a lot of confusion happening here.
Because, well, I mean, that would have been a really interesting idea. That, now that would have flown really well with me. As in flown really well, it's like, I would have really respected that communicative package. So if, rhetorically, mm-hmm. you make the statement, okay, let's reverse roles.
Right.
Now, all these ads that are based off of body, and like, mm-hmm. when you're using the female body to sell a product, or like, that's what we're like, now men will be there. And now instead of maybe women laying all over the yacht, it's men.
It's men,
but
yeah.
she didn't do that. It's yeah. very... So now all of a sudden it's reversed. We were using man being a male stereotype.
Right.
Excuse me?
That's the third phone call I've gotten. Okay.
And now, like, she's throwing this in at the end, like a little, like a second thought. Like
yeah.
an afterthought.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
Taylor...
It's
Sugar,
just not doing...
Sugar, what are you doing? This just doesn't make sense.
It's just not doing anything that I understand.
Yeah, I'm not sure this was really... I think this is not really living up to the hype that I was hoping. Taylor Swift usually does really an amazing job with music videos as communicating a very...
like, clear point.
Yeah, like a clear message, but then she also is really amazing at, like, you know, little Easter eggs and all these
mm-hmm.
little things. And then, oh, Wildest Dreams, favorite music video of all time. And this is really disappointing to me.
Yeah.
Because I'm not even that upset because I don't really even understand really what's happening.
I mean, yeah, that is true.
Besides
I really
that,
don't know what's
okay,
going
we
on.
Okay, we all understand that you obviously, like, there's this male kind of two-dimensional stereotype.
Right.
Okay, let's
And we still don't
up.
Really know what is wrong with it.
Yeah. Well, we know what's wrong, but just, like...
By the way, excellent work over there, Lauren. That was astonishing.
Thanks.
Oh.
Oh,
called
she...
It.
Oh, yeah.
Here it comes.
There
called
it, goes.
It. Owned by Taylor Swift.
What are you...
Starring Taylor Swift. Voice The Man by Dwayne Johnson.
Okay, that's
no
actually hilarious.
No men were harmed during this... Video, is that what it said?
And that is what it said. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, we love
2020,
that.
Taylor Swift.
That's right, because,
oh.
Because women are always getting harmed in those music videos. Actually,
right.
maybe some of those rap videos, you're wondering,
yeah,
are you?
That's okay. a little intense.
There's a lot happening. Okay, so final thoughts? We're wrapping up thoughts. What do you say?
So anyways, my final thoughts on this are that it didn't really make sense, honestly. I don't really see what Taylor Swift was trying to do with this because there was, like we talked about, there was like the role reversal
mm-hmm.
where it was obvious that she was trying to say that women are treated a certain way in certain scenarios. And then there was also just the regular part, I guess you could say, where the guy was just like on top of the world and did whatever he wanted and was in the way and just treated
yeah,
women
this
poorly.
Douchebag character.
Yeah.
Which, I don't know, that just, okay. My final thoughts are that same, I retweet 100%. What is the message? I'm a little confused, except that we all don't like this douchebag character. This
right.
kind of very two-dimensional douchebag character. But was that something that we needed to be taught? I think no one really is drawn towards that. In a way, it's like, oh, man, you're right. I've now been, my eyes have been opened.
Yeah.
I would also like to say, though, that hurt people hurt people. So just because someone is a douchebag does not mean that they're not a human.
Yes.
Also, I think that's another thing, too, is when we collapse people down to a stereotype.
Yes.
What are we doing? Also, there's a lot of harm in that. I think it's like collapsing people into a stereotype has been harmful to people of all types for
mm-hmm.
millennia. If you think about how you know, African-American stereotypes were used in pop culture in the early 1900s.
Yes.
That was collapsing people down into a stereotype.
Right.
And they're only this kind of like, this stupid, you know, over-dramatic depiction.
Mm-hmm.
And that seems kind of sad if that's really what we're... I had the same thought in that other music video she did. What was it? Gosh, she's in the trailer park. Do you know what I'm talking about at all? The song?
Yes, I do, I do.
Do you know what I'm talking about?
Mm-hmm, I do know what song that is.
You need to calm down. Calm down.
Yes.
Where the anti-gay...
Calm down.
People... The anti-gay people were collapsed into a stereotype. And one, that is a mental shortcut, so it doesn't
mm-hmm.
really allow for critical thought.
Right.
It's collapsing people into a stereotype and then just leaving them there and
mm-hmm.
saying, you should just be mad at these people for the stereotype. It's not
right.
asking any more questions. And then it's also the reality of like, well, you've now devalued that person because that's a person too.
Right.
People believe things for reasons.
Yes.
Not just because... Like, oh, this group of people hate these people, and no one knows why. But we, like, now granted, are those, you know, valid reasons, or are they, you know, like, those are questions that you get into, but there's, like, people believe things for reasons. They have good, yeah, we can cut that out, so just go ahead, answer away.
I'm so sorry.
Hello?
People believe things for a reason. That's
yes.
really what my bottom line was, is that, so if the purpose is... critical thinking
mm-hmm.
and let's try to solve problems
mm-hmm.
like the way that men and women are viewed, and maybe especially women are viewed, or this idea that women are devalued in our society and therefore they don't get as far. I would push back against that, well, specifically not to all women, but specifically to Taylor Swift, being that she is like, one, has used her femininity in her career,
yes.
and is one of the wealthiest, most popular, most powerful celebrities in the world.
Right.
And she's used her femininity as part of that. It's hard for me to at least believe that if she was a boy, she would be... had gotten there faster, because sugar, she's only 26.
I mean, yeah, she's like 25 or something, but she started her career when she was still in high school, pretty
yeah,
much.
I think younger than that.
Really?
Well, I mean, when she first started singing.
Yeah.
So she rose to fame very quickly. As it pertains to this video and the song,
mm-hmm.
the message seems to be in the song, like, if I'm tired of guys getting ahead in the world,
mm-hmm.
and that's hard coming from her.
Yeah.
And that, again... what she has done at least twice now is, like, in order to further her case that this is someone we shouldn't like, she's condensed people down to a stereotype.
Right.
And that's what I think when I watch this, watch her do it twice, that's what I have problems with, because that's cheap.
Yeah.
Like, everyone dislikes a stereotype where they're portrayed as just a horrible person.
Yeah, exactly.
Because that's very easy to do, and so it's, and it requires, like, of course we don't like that caricature,
mm-hmm.
you know? And that's weak. Like, that's
yeah.
cheap.
And the same way that you said earlier before I talked about the ice cream story was, like, if it were to say, you know, how some places are, like, straight white men don't even bother applying here, blah, blah,
mm-hmm.
if a place were to actually be, like, black women don't apply here, or,
yeah.
you know, Hispanic men don't apply here, blah, blah, it would be off the chain. Like, it would be ridiculous.
Yeah.
Like, nobody would go there. Yeah, nobody would go there, all
this
stuff. And then if, in the same way, if Taylor Swift were to make a video that was called something else, like, if it was called, like, Hispanic woman or something,
yeah,
and the entire thing was depicting how terrible the stereotype for Hispanic women was,
yeah,
she would be, like, blacklisted.
Yeah, or black women, because Beyonce is a huge star, or, like, so many
right.
women of African American descent
mm-hmm.
are enormous, like, stars on the planet.
Mm-hmm.
Like, wow, if I was an African American woman, wouldn't things be great for me? Like,
yeah.
Okay.
Mm.
I don't know. Maybe I would say if she was sitting here, which Taylor Swift, where
yeah.
are you?
Taylor.
Go ahead and come in, Taylor. Let's bring Taylor Swift out.
She just walked out from the back.
It's like Maury, hey, she's screaming.
What did you say about me? Get away from me!
Oh my gosh.
I think she would probably say, well, we have this history of a lot of male privilege. Mm-hmm. And so therefore we have to kind of balance the scales. And to that, Taylor Swift, I would say it's not that simple. I would argue that, especially when it comes to gender, do you need to answer that?
No.
Okay.
I don't think so.
Especially when it comes to gender, it's just complicated.
No.
Not denying privilege, but just also like what is, there's the four calls.
I'm telling you, what's up with that?
There, it's complicated, not in that privilege doesn't exist, but just like what is privilege. Okay, well, I can't go on too many other rabbit trails. Anyway, I think the bottom line is, one, we both agreed that this was kind of weak sauce as far as what the video meant.
Yeah.
Just because we're not sure.
I was hoping for a better plot and more Easter eggs.
More, yeah. I wanted some more Easter
eggs. Yeah. I wanted some more Easter eggs before we were out, but...
And then secondly, that, you know, should I say it? We'll do it. Shame on you, Taylor Swift, for condensing someone into a... For condensing people into stereotypes, because
should
that
I say it?
Is it. Should I?
I shame will. On you. Tis tis, Taylor. So anyways, Austin, thank you for joining me today. We're going to cut it off here, guys. Again, this is Austinave, and I am Anna Boulevard, and we are signing off.
Stay studly, guys.